One of the first workshops I went to, and in fact it was in this hotel, was by a hardcore neuroscientist, Jeffrey Schwartz, his name is there. His study is in obsessive compulsive disorder, so he absolutely knows the brain and knows the power of the brain to hold us, you know, entrapped, if you like, in what goes on. And this was a saying that he brought out. He said, look, the brain of the leader shapes the brains of the rest of the organization. What do you think? Yes, no? Does it make sense? Yeah, can you think of any examples? Steve Jobs? Yep. Donald Trump? And Bill Gates? Any of the ones we can see? It's really interesting when you start to look at this. Now, the detail here and the interesting thing is this is happening at a physiological level. And this is what's fascinated me and changed my perspective on leadership. This is not a psychological impact alone that you're having. What we know is the brain rewires according to what is focused on. So if I need to learn to drive, I focus on driving, and eventually driving becomes automatic pilot. If I come into a workplace and everybody says good morning cheerfully, and we always say good morning cheerfully, my brain wires that when I walk into this workplace, I say good morning cheerfully. So the brain of the leader, and this is why I'm concerned if we're running in anxiety and if we're running in stress, and if we're running in frustration and judgment of our leadership, that is exactly what our teams will pick up. And that is exactly the culture we will mold. Now, this from a management point of view, some of you will be familiar with it, but this is one of the best tools I have ever come across. In industry, in general industry and management, it's known as a balanced scorecard. And the idea is that it keeps us consciously focused on not staying focused in only one area. So this is what helps us to move away from only focusing on finance or only focusing on poor behavior or whatever it might be. If I come back to this, essentially if you're providing a healthcare service, you have four things you must focus on. And they all do work in tandem. Sometimes it can feel like they're contradictory, but the challenge of leadership is to get the four of them really working well together. So the first thing is you want the service to be safe and to be quality. So I know I'm going to a quality restaurant or I'm buying a quality handbag if I get it from a certain shop or go to a certain restaurant, because I know consistently and reliably this restaurant or this shop provides good food, good handbags, good shoes. And what we've often got in healthcare is mood-dependent healthcare. Consider it. If we've got mood-dependent healthcare, then we have not got safe healthcare and we have not got reliable healthcare. Because if on one shift I'm okay to ask a question if I'm uncertain, but if in another one I'll be humiliated, then the clients, the residents, the patients do not have reliable healthcare. So this is where we can start to move issues around performance. It's not personalized. It's not about whether I'm going to make you cry. It's about whether we are creating an environment that is consistently safe for these patients. And it so happens my role is to keep the bird's eye view. And my bird's eye view currently is indicating that a couple of things that I need to be precise with you about are meaning that we do not have reliable care, or are leading to a risk in safety because people don't feel they can ask you questions, or are affecting our team's vitality because your mind and the attitude you bring on this day dampens everybody or lifts everybody if we focus on it, make it aware. Or it's challenging our patient's experience or our family's experience who need a deep confidence in us, or it's impacting on our efficiency or effectiveness. Now, in a longer session, and I'll be around for lunchtime if anybody wants to chat, they all tend to interact. Because if I have a bunch of sulky staff, then I know that the patient's experience is going to drop. If the patient's experience is drop, They don't sleep as well, they don't eat as well, they don't drink as well, they don't move as well, they don't interact as well. So therefore my safety and quality of my care is going to go down. And if the safety and quality of my care is going to go down, I'm perpetually having to bring in more allied health or different medications or whatever, and my costs and finances are going to start moving up. So all of them will have a flow-on effect to each other. And once you've got this framework of four, it's amazing for lobbying, it's fabulous for management upwards, and it's very, very good as well for managing your team and for setting your visions in terms of where we're going to go.